So I got a request to do a makeup tutorial using the Naked 3 palette because, because I haven't done one yet and I've been playing around with it for a couple, I got it for Christmas, so I've been playing around with it for a couple weeks and this is the look that I like the best so far that I've come up with. It just turned out like kind of like a mauve-y, purpley, smoky eye. Anyways, I don't know. If you want to know how I got this look, then just keep watching.
Okay. You don't have to have the Naked 3 palette to do this. Just find your own colors that look like this, okay? You don't have to spend $50. I didn't. I got it for a Christmas present, so. Just saying. Okay, let's go.
Oh, look so sad because we look like a scary no makeup person, but magic fixes it. Just kidding, it's makeup. Haha, okay. Back to no makeup. So I'm going to start with putting a concealer all over my eye just because I've got some seriously weird veiny eyelids and whatever. I don't like to talk about it. It's not that weird. And I'm just blending that in with a brush because I'm feeling lazy today. So yeah, but that's that. After that's all done, I'm just going to take this matte cream color. This is the only color I'm not using from the Naked 3 palette and I'm putting that all over my lid. Then I'm going to start with the crease color, so I'm going in with Limit, which is like a matte gray-purpley color. I don't really know how to describe it. Anyways, I'm just going to put that on my crease. This is going to be our like transition color for blending and just greatness, you know? Okay, after you have all that blended into your crease, you're going to go in with Nooner, which is basically the same color, just a few shades darker. It's also matte, and I'm going to put that also in my crease, but focus it more on the outer corner and kind of bring it into the inner corner just a little bit. I just like to build up the blendedness and then, you know, whatever. Start small, work your way up. That's what I always say. Ha ha ha. I don't actually. I've never said that. Then I'm going in with Factory, which is a darker color and it's more of like a metallic color. And I'm putting that in my outer corner and I'm just like kind of making a shape of the outer V with it because I don't want to drag it too far into the inner corner. And I'm just blending. And basically what I'm doing now is I'm just going back and forth between adding more Factory and blending it out with Limit, the color we started with. So yeah, you can just go back and forth and do that until you have the desired color you want. Smoky factor, I don't know, whatever. So yeah, just mainly a lot of blending. You really want to blend. I think the key to a good eyeshadow look is seriously blending. Blend forever. That's all I gotta say. Okay, moving on. Then I'm gonna do the lid colors. I'm going in with Strange, which is just a white. It's not completely matte, but basically. And I'm putting that all over my lid. It's gonna act as the base color because I'm putting Dust over it, which is more of a glitter color. It doesn't come up with a lot of pigmentation, so I like to use my finger to just pat it on all over my lid. And the reason I'm putting this on after is because if we put it on before, all the blending would make the glittery fall off, and we don't want that. So yeah, after that, I'm just taking a makeup wipe, and I'm going to clean up the edge. You can use tape if you want. It's just easy to use a makeup wipe. Then I'm going to prime my face and do the rest of my makeup because, I mean, you don't have to. You can go out with just eye makeup on, but I got a weird face, pale face compared to my body. Then I'm going to put my foundation on. I'm using the Maybelline Superstay, which is one of my favorites. And I'm just plopping that all over my face like I normally do, just dotting it on like a little Dalmatian. A Dalmatian, yep, okay. Then I'm just buffing it in with this Real Techniques brush that I just bought, and I'm actually seriously obsessed with it. I used it for like almost everything today. I don't know. It's very versatile, let's just say that. Anyways. Yeah, it's just so soft and amazing. Ugh, I can just imagine it on my face right now, even though I'm not even doing my makeup. Okay, after that's blended in, I'm going to go in with my concealer. I'm using this e.l.f. one. It's alright. I don't know. Anyways, then I'm putting that under my eyes, and if I have any blemishes, which the foundation pretty much covered everything, so I don't need to go back over them. And I'm just blending that in with my fingers because I'm lazy and I don't want to get another brush. Ha ha ha. Okay, and after that's all blended in, I'm going to go in with the powder that I'm using. I'm using this Jordana one. I like it because it gives a little bit of coverage. It's like a medium coverage powder. And I'm taking the Real Technique brush, haha, shocker, and I'm buffing that all over my foundation to set it and add a little extra coverage because, you know me, I like to be a cake face. Ah! Sorry, hiccup. Anyways, after you're done buffing that all into the skin and you have the desired amount of cakiness, I'm going to go in and do my bronzer, which is another thing I like to go overboard on, and I'm literally just putting that all over my face. I'm really going crazy. Go crazy with a bronzer, you guys. Don't judge me. Don't judge anyone. People should be able to bronze as much as they want without feeling judged, okay? Okay, so I'm just going to continue to do this for a long time. Good thing it's fast-forwarded, because this is like one of the longest steps of my makeup. There I am with a Real Techniques brush again. I just can't let it go. And after that, I'm going to go in and contour, and I actually didn't film a clip of the product I used, but I used the Revlon Photo Ready Matte Bronzer. So here I am contouring, but yeah, haha, I'm stupid and didn't get the clip. I'm just using the Real Techniques contour brush, also obsessed with it, and then, what do you know, I'm blending it out with the Real Techniques, whatever, I can speak well, buffing brush. Then I'm going to go in my blush. I'm using this Milani brush, it's called Rosy Odoro, I don't know. Haha, shocker, using the buffing brush, why can't I speak? And I'm just putting that on the hollows of my cheek, and bringing it a little bit on the apples of my cheek, and look at the cute faces I make when I put makeup on. So cute. Then I'm going to go in and do my highlighter. And I'm using this hard candy one. It's very pretty. Very, very pretty. And I'm using the Real Techniques brush again. Seriously, it's all you ever need in life. And I'm just putting that on my cheeks, nose, forehead, anywhere I want. Then I'm going to go in and finish the eyes. I'm going in with my highlight, which is just the strange color that we use all over the lid. And then I'm going in with Factory and lining the outer corner of my eye. Just a little bit, nothing crazy. Then I'm going in with Dust and putting that a little bit in the inner corner. And then it's time for the lips. I took two because the first one made me look dead. So I took the darker one to make me look not dead. And I'm just slapping that on my lips like I normally would. Just plop it on there. See, look how light it is. And it's got such a weird smell. I'm not a fan, but I like the colors of this nude line, so I'll deal. Then I'm going to go in with this lippy gloss from NYX. It's called Sugar Pie. It's really pretty. And I'm just putting that on, whatever. Make your lips all shiny, whatnot. And then you're done! I hope you guys liked it. If you did, make sure you subscribe, like the video, and leave any video requests below. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye!